Today we're here to learn about contacts, context folders, and sharing contacts in Outlook 2010. So for today's example, I've set up a example contact folder, and I'm going to make another folder in which I'll share with a coworker. This is an example of a shared contact. I have from Elizabeth here a CETL group, and this is something that I don't own. She owns that, and if she updated that, I would also get the updates. So that's useful, and I hope that you can find some good uses for shared contacts as well. I have my contact examples, and these are things that I want to keep inside of my own. These are my personal contacts. But let's say I want to make a folder of example contacts that I want to share. The first thing I'm going to do is right-click. These are actually folders inside of this contact group, so I know that they have different images than a folder, but that's really what they are, is folders. So if I right-click, I'm going to get an option of making a new folder. And it doesn't do too much. I'm going to put it just inside of my contacts folder. And I'll call this example contacts for sharing. And I'm just going to put it under my main contacts folder. And I'll say OK. So here it's down here in the list. And I just simply grabbed this and dragged it around to reorganize it. So inside here, I'm going to actually move Bill Gates into my example contacts for sharing. So what am I doing? I'm clicking and dragging. Now, you may not have the same view of your contacts as I do. And if I wanted to change that, I could go to the View tab. And I would change my view. And maybe you've got it in list format. This can be useful as well. So here's Bill Gates again, and I'm going to drag that into example contacts for sharing because I want to share that with my coworker. I'm going to drag this Barack Obama contact in as well, but for this, I don't want to have it live in there. I'm just going to make a copy. So just for the sake of examples, on my keyboard, I'm going to hold down Control. And do you see that there's a little plus? I'm going to let go of Control. Do you see that this plus thing shows up when I hit Control on my keyboard? That plus indicates it's making a copy and not dragging the original. So here I go. I'm going to copy Barack Obama into the example contacts. Okay, so now here in my contacts examples, I have only Barack Obama, and if I go to my contacts examples for sharing, I've got Bill Gates and Barack Obama in here. All right, so here's now the crux is the sharing aspect. Some of these other ones have little hands underneath them. This means I've shared these three folders, and now I'm going to put a little hand under this one. This is going to be something I'm going to share as well. This is not to be confused with this little icon where I have a blue arrow, which means someone shared this with me. I'm not the owner. I'm going to initialize sharing. I'm going to right-click on my contact folder. When I go right-click on there, I'll find the Share menu, and I'm going to share this contact. And this actually brought up an email. I'll try to resize it. Okay, and in this email, I can send to anyone I want. So in this situation, I'll send to Alan, not at you. And perhaps I want Alan to be able to add and edit and delete things inside this contacts folder. And here's my little message to him. When I hit send, that'll go off to him, and it's changing the settings on my folder, so I'll hit yes. And he's now received that, and he can open that. When he opens it, it's going to open in his contacts, very similar to how Elizabeth's is showing up here in mine right now. I'd like to just to say, I go into my share, and if I just did that share contacts, that's in the email. But let's pretend like I want to Alan is no longer in our office, or I want to kind of see what's going on with my folder, I can come to folder permissions here. And now I see that Alan is in here, and I could add people or remove people as I needed to. So that's how you can change it once you get started. So I hope that that is a useful function for you. And I hope that it aids you in your office efficiency. Any questions, check out the CETL website, come to a tech training, or give us a call at CETL.